Hey everyone, welcome back to Maple Syrup Gaming. So today, I thought it'd be fun to take a look at predictions for the Nintendo Switch Pro or a revision of the Nintendo Switch that could be coming out in 2020. Now, what brought along this video is basically with everyone knowing that for holiday season 2020, both the PlayStation 5 and the Xbox Series X are going to be hitting. Well, of course, the rumors have started up again of what will Nintendo do to counteract the launch of these two products, or will they do anything at all? So what I thought would be really fun would be to go through what are five predictions that I have for features that could be included in a Nintendo Switch revision, or call it a Nintendo Switch Pro. And just for, you know, ease of this video, I'll just call it the Nintendo Switch Pro from now on, but who knows what they might actually call it. Now, the way we're going to go through the features is we're going to start with those features that are more obvious. The ones that I think everyone is predicting that if a Nintendo Switch Pro does drop, are pretty much going to be included in this second console. And we're going to move on to those features that I am sort of predicting that are a little more out there, that maybe not all of you out there have thought about. And as we know, Nintendo's are the pro company for going in a direction that we never see coming. So I think there's a couple of features that might be included on a Nintendo Switch Pro that might take a lot of you guys by surprise. And we're going to put those at the end of our list just because, you know, since there are predictions that are a little more out there, we're going to keep them as, you know, a little sweetener at the end. And by the way, I would really like to hear what you guys think could be included in a Nintendo Switch Pro if it does come out this year, because if I get a lot of ideas from you guys, we might do a part two to this video based on your predictions rather than my predictions. So I would really like to get that going. So do drop in the comments what you guys think about my predictions and what you guys also think will be included in a Nintendo Switch Pro. I think doing these videos are really fun just because we can look at them at the end of the year if one does actually drop and say, hey, you know, I was right, or this person was right, or whatnot. Now, the first and probably most obvious feature that I think a lot of people would point to a Nintendo Switch Pro would be a boost in resolution for the console. Because we already know that even now, based on the Nintendo Switch is significantly behind even the PlayStation 4 and the Xbox One when we're talking about raw, you know, graphical power. However, at the same time, I don't think Nintendo will be aiming for that 4K. I know a lot of people are talking about a Nintendo Switch Pro that can put out some 4K, but I really don't think that Nintendo would aim at that simply because the gap is too wide. What I think Nintendo would rather aim at, and if we look at the rumors that have dropped so far, is that they've ordered IGZO screens from Sharp. Now, these are screens that focus, yes, you could get 4K out of them, but they're rather screens that focus on better power consumption and also higher refresh or frame rates. So basically, I think what Nintendo would do in a revision is rather than aim for that 4K, is it would aim for full HD, whether it's in docked or in handheld mode, and more evenly across all games. Because unfortunately right now, there are games, for example, like The Witcher 3, that is not running at full HD, or at least not at good quality full HD when it's docked, simply because the game is too demanding on the Nintendo Switch. Now, basically, what I would think in a revision is that Nintendo will aim for a higher frame rate across games, maybe even being able to get up to that 120 FPS for some games, but have a more steady, like 30 or 60 frames per second at better quality across all its games that are already out for its library. But, like I said, that's only my prediction. Let me know what you guys think about that. Do you think they'll aim 4K, or do you think they'll aim for a higher refresh rate? Now, number two on the list of obvious upgrades for a Nintendo Switch Pro, I think would be the storage capacity. Because although when the Nintendo Switch Pro launched 2 years ago, 32 gigabytes was probably considered pretty decent for having, you know, a few games directly on the console, but now with the proficiency of basically downloading and buying digital games, the necessity for higher storage is really become important. And although I would never remove the necessity for having additional storage added, you know, in the form of micro SD cards or whatnot, I do think that the base console, Nintendo should start aiming at including, for example, 128 gigabytes or higher, especially if you're launching a console that you want to call a premium console. Simply because people are going to be expecting that if you launch a premium console, you don't right away have to buy a micro SD card to be able to, you know, have a decent library of games. And since a lot of games now can go up to almost 25-30 gigabytes of download space to install them on your system, well, I think that 128 gigabytes would be the minimum that Nintendo has to aim for if they're going to be launching a premium console or a revision, as the base storage included. Now, third on my list would be connectivity features. Basically, if Nintendo releases a Pro console, I would really like them to aim more towards the streaming or video recording side of things. A lot of people nowadays, when you play your games, they want the ability to stream their console. They want the ability to connect to the internet with really, really decent speeds. And it was okay to not include, for example, an Ethernet port on the original Switch and having to buy a USB dongle. But on a premium console, once again, I think that this is going to be a feature that would have to be included on the base console itself. Have an Ethernet port on there, and I think that Nintendo should even go a step further and really focus on the streaming and video recording capabilities of the system, like that 30-second, you know, screen capture that they offer right now to get the last 30 seconds of video is perfectly fine on the base Switch. But if you really want to push your console with the next generation consoles, I think that they should include base streaming capabilities in the Switch. Although a lot of people are still going to be going for separate capture cards, nonetheless, they should at least offer some basic streaming capabilities and also the ability to record video at more than 30 seconds at a time. So now we got through the three features that I think were not surprising to any of you out there. Now, those first three features, like I said, screen resolution, higher storage, and better internet capabilities are things that people have been asking from the Switch for a long time. So it's not really a surprise that if Nintendo would do a Pro Edition console, they would look at what people are requesting or what people are talking about and include it in that system. However, the last two predictions or the last two features that I think could be included in the Nintendo Switch, once again, are a little bit more out there. So that brings us to number four, which is my first prediction that I think might take a lot of you by surprise, and that would be the inclusion of base VR with the next edition Pro console. Now, you're thinking VR, it's not a huge success, and you're right. However, if we look, Nintendo has already dabbled in this in the past. Take Labo, for example. It wasn't a huge success, but nonetheless, it did prove that the base Nintendo Switch console could be used for basic VR. And in the last few months, they've even launched Ring Fit Adventure, which is a method of getting people up and interacting with the game in a much more physical way. So imagine you bring these two concepts together in a next generation Switch, and you push it with higher resolution on the base console, and on top of it all, you could even throw in maybe basic 3D capabilities. Now, we know Nintendo already has the technology out there with what they did with the 3DS and whatnot. Well, imagine if they integrated a base form of 3D on the next edition Pro console for those that really wanted to experience VR. And the big, big revolution in all this is rather than having to invest hundreds of extra dollars to get VR on your system, you could only sell a more premium, you know, forget that cardboard Labo headset, just a basic, decent headset to rest the Switch on your head. And you could really, really get VR going for maybe an extra $100. You just buy that headset and you got VR running. And they could even include retrocompatibility with the original Switch. However, your experience will be a little bit diminished because perhaps the 3D capability won't be there or the resolution will be lower. And you have a really revolutionary console that might finally get VR really into the mainstream gaming community. Now we get to the last and maybe most out there feature that Nintendo might include in a future console. Now, the compatibility with 3DS cartridges was actually something that a lot of people were hoping would be included on the original Switch. But what if it's a feature that they were reserving for the next generation Switch? because they wanted to see first of all if the Switch would actually catch on as a system. And now they would be ready to release it in a Pro Edition. Alongside that, it would probably not be hard to make it software compatible with the original Switch simply through game downloads. Now this would automatically double or even triple the size of the Nintendo Switch library of available games and actually give a reason for the leftover holdouts from the 3DS era to finally maybe purchase a new edition Nintendo Switch Pro. Because they could bring their base library with them of games that they already have and play them on the Switch, and have a compatibility in dock mode to play them on a television set. Now I know what all of you guys out there are thinking, what about those 3DS games that required a touchscreen? Well, number one, the base Switch is already a touchscreen, meaning that when you're using it in handheld mode, it's most likely not going to be very difficult to get the games compatible with a Switch in tablet mode. And if we switch to my side camera for a second, just imagine the already existent dog face controller, simply a little bit larger and with a touchscreen in the center. Honestly, you could really convert 3DS games for a cheap price, because a touchscreen, by the way, and the one that you saw that I placed on the controller is an actual 3DS touchscreen. They're sold for like $5 on the open market, meaning that manufacturers pay even less for that, and it could be an additional accessory that you could buy maybe for your OG Switch for when you buy the 3DS games in digital format. And the proof to this possibility doesn't even stop there. Just think of Nintendo refusing for the moment to admit that the 3DS is fully discontinued. They're still producing the 2DS and the 2DS XL, and they haven't wanted to say officially that the 2DS and 3DS line of systems was officially discontinued or that their time was over. Maybe it's because they've already announced to manufacturers that this is something that will be coming, and manufacturers are planning re-releases of some of their classic games at a lower price. Imagine if you could replay 3DS games that would be re-released sort of in compilations, and you would get them for a much lower price than they were launched for originally. And last is maybe point that Nintendo maybe dropped as hints that this could be coming would be, in the last year they've actually released a couple of games at the same time on the 3DS and the Switch. Captain Toad Treasure Tracker and Yoshi's Woolly World were released both on the Nintendo Switch and the 3DS at the same time. And this was maybe sort of a test just to see what kind of compatibility they could get out of software between the Switch and the 3DS line of systems. Now, all this is just a huge theory, and I just really find it fun to think about these things, but imagine if Nintendo did go down that road. So rather than compete with Xbox and PS5 on the side of power, which we already know is not their plan, they really went, like they said, with getting the hugest install base possible and the hugest library of physical games available on their system. And I think one of the best ways they could do it would be to automatically include the whole 3DS library of games natively compatible with the system. So now that's pretty much it for my list of features that I would like to see on the next generation Switch. Now I'd really like to hear from you guys out there. Like I said in this video before, I want to hear what you guys think or would like to have included on a next generation Switch. So please drop it in the comments down below. I'll be reading them all and trying to reply as many of them as I can. At the same time, please don't forget to drop a like on the video if you liked it, to subscribe if you aren't already, and activate that notification bell so you know when I come out with other videos. I want to thank you guys so much for watching, and as usual, as in every video, I hope I'll catch you guys in my next one.